Hello everyone. In this video, we will see what different operations can be performed on a PDF file using different components from IntelliBot Studio. So let's go ahead and create a new robotic process automation project. Let's call it PDF. Then we'll go to the main activity. So going to the main activity, on the left side of the studio, we'll have a toolbox. Under toolbox, let's go ahead and search for PDF. So under utilities, we have different components for PDF. So these components will help us perform different operations on a PDF file. We will be going through each of these components one by one. So the first component here is convert to HTML. Let's drag this component and drop it on the design surface. It takes three inputs. First one is PDF file path. The next one is page number. And the third one is whether or not to use the same font size. So let's go ahead and provide the PDF file path. Providing 0 in page number will convert all pages in the PDF file. So let's go ahead and execute this component. This will return a string which will contain the HTML for the PDF document. So the next component here is getText. This helps us read PDF files and extract text from it. It again takes as input the PDF file path and the page number and returns us the string. So let's go ahead and execute this. And here we have the data from the PDF file. Next component here is convert to doc. This helps us to convert PDF files to Word documents. Let's go ahead, provide it PDF file path and the Word file path where we want to convert the PDF file and save it. So we have kept the extension as docx for the same file at the same folder location. So run from here, it will go ahead and convert the PDF into a docx file and store it at the same place. The next component here is convert to Excel. So this helps us convert a PDF file to an Excel file, taking a PDF file path input and an Excel file. So let's save it as XLSX. And run this component. So we can see the file has been converted to an Excel file and saved here. One important thing to note is the PDF file will contain tables, so only the tables from the PDF file will get converted to Excel. Next component we have is convert to image. So this helps us convert a particular page from a PDF file to an image. So the first input will be the PDF file path. The second one will be image path. Let's specify it as temp.jpg. The third one will be a page number. So let's say we want to convert the first page. This is DPI. So for changing resolution of in what resolution we want to save, we can change it accordingly. Let's leave it at 200. And this is the quality of the image. So let's go ahead and run this component. So it goes ahead and converts the first page in the PDF to an image. Next component we have here is convert to images. So this helps us convert all pages of a particular PDF file to images. So we have to specify the PDF file path here, folder path where we have to save the images. We don't have to specify a particular page image name. It will save it as page number 1, page 2, page 3 and so on. So let's leave the DPI and quality same as it is, and it also returns us the list with the file names that it stores the images with. Once we run from here, we'll have a list of names. So it was stored, page 1 was stored at this position, page 2 was stored at this position. If we go ahead and check, here we have our page 1 and page 2. Next component we have here is convert to tables. So this component helps us to convert a PDF file into tables and returns it as a list. So run from here, this will return us a list. Next component we have is convert to XML. Here we provide the PDF file path, the XML file path, the convert tables only as true helps us to convert only the tables from the PDF file. If this made false, everything will be converted to a XML file. And the page number, if specified 0, will take all pages. Next component we have is extract images. So this helps us to convert. This helps us to extract images from a particular page of a PDF file. So the PDF file we are using here does not have any images, but in case there are images on a particular page, let's say there are 3 images on a particular page, it will help us extract all 3 images from a particular page and store in this folder path location. Next component we have here is get all tables. This also takes input as a PDF file path and returns as a list all the tables. Next component we have is get page as image. So this helps us convert a particular page into an image. So it takes a PDF file path and the page number. The next component is get page count. It takes a PDF file path, returns as an integer how many pages that PDF file has. So the last component we have here is get table. So this is a very important component. We drag and drop it on the design surface. To configure this, we have to double click on this component. This helps us to extract a particular table from a PDF file. So we can extract the table by 2 ways. The first one is through an index. So for extracting the first table, let's say we'll give the index as 0 or 1, 2, 3 for whichever table we want to extract. Or the other way to extract a table is contains text. Through this, we can provide a particular string and it will go ahead and search for that string in all tables. And if any table contains that string, it will be extracted and returned to us as a data table, which can be used further during automations. So let's go ahead, provide the file path here and extract as index. So let's try and extract the first table, run from here. So here we get a table. So this is the first table in the PDF file, which is extracted here. We can try extracting the second table or the third table as well. So this is the second table. So this is how simple it is to extract tables through this get table component. That's pretty much it about different operations that can be performed on PDF files through IntelliBot Studio. Thank you.